Every day around the world, thousands of children are lured and trapped in the abusive web of trafficking. Young girls and boys from Southeast Asian countries are not exempt from this modern-day slavery. According to local NGOs, many of them are trafficked into Malaysia each year and are forced into prostitution or bonded labor. The growing trade in human flesh in this dynamic and economically vibrant region represents nearly one-third of the global trafficking trade. Exact numbers, however, are hard to pinpoint since child trafficking is hidden, mostly out of sight, and victims often fear coming forward. Bringing to light this largely underground and exploitative crime, UNICEF Malaysia hosted a luncheon in conjunction with World Day for Prevention of Child Abuse, which brought together more than 50 representatives of Malaysian and foreign media, including editors, producers, and senior reporters. Professor Yap Dok, chairman of the United Nations Committee on the Rights of the Child and the luncheon's keynote speaker, called on the Malaysian government to formulate bilateral agreements with neighboring Asian countries pertaining to child trafficking. He said it was essential that all Southeast Asian nations cooperate to eradicate the world's second most lucrative cross-border crime.
I think given the nature of trafficking and trafficking not only for children but women and others as well, you really should bring together neighboring countries, assuming that even trafficking is not limited to two countries. You may have three countries, you may even have more countries. In terms of transit from the one country to the other, and ultimately you go to the country of destination. But I think it's important for the whole region to understand that only a collaborative effort can really address and reduce trafficking.
But governments alone cannot fight the war against child trafficking. According to UNICEF, the media plays a crucial role in reducing such exploitation. Many families and children are dependent on the media not only for news and entertainment, but also for education of social issues. Media reporting of trafficking issues can also encourage and influence others, including governments and civil society, to respond to the problem. Additionally, the media can help shape positive attitudes towards victims of trafficking so they are not criminalized. Once rescued, survivors should be assisted to return to their home communities.
I think the Malaysian media should actually do more because the youth and the children are future generations and they need to be taken care of from the right from the start. But whether the media will take up the challenge to do it immediately, I'm not sure, but there's always hope. But definitely, definitely, the media should do a lot more.
In collaboration with the government, civil society and the media, UNICEF Malaysia is committed to securing a protective environment for women and children, free from the tragic consequences of trafficking. This is Lydia Luban reporting for UNICEF. For Every Child, Advance Humanity.